November, and our congregation has been discussing the topic on whether we should fund visual arts. The early church supported this for many good reasons. For example, it helped the unlearned or the common man understand the scriptures, but it also brought the scriptures to life for the educated. But the Protestants challenged this, believing it led to idolatry. But Casey is here to talk about our church today.
Well, Amber mentioned how the early church actually used visual arts and really preferred them. But actually, also in the Old Testament, it's also mentioned that God even actually used fine arts and visual arts to send messages to his people. For example,
God even used the rainbow that he created to send a message to his people that he would never flood the earth again. And he also had the people build a sculpture, or a big thing, called the Ark of the Covenant. And it also held the very sacred commandments.
And in today's world, visual arts are everywhere. They're all around us. We actually live in a very visual world. For instance, throughout our buildings, there are sculptures, there are food items, there are all these different visual forms of arts that we use. We use them to identify with them and the objects and the meaning that they're trying to portray to us. They also evoke powerful emotions. For example, we all know the Williams Prayer Chapel, and the sculptures that are in there are very powerful, and it helps us to connect with God. That's the thing about Christian visual art, is that if you have it in the right context, in the right way, it also helps you to understand and connect with God even more than just thinking. It's a tangible thing that you can connect with.
If God gave us the ability to create just like Him,
why not put it in the place of worship?
That's why we should have visual fine arts in our church.